Hello, I'm Dr Maria Ubiali. I'm a lecturer in the Department of Applied Mathematics and Theoretical Physics, and I'm a Sheila Edmund Lecturer at Newnham College and Director of Studies in Maths. I would now like to guide you into the beautiful world of particle physics. I was born in a town near Milan in Italy, and I always wanted to be an artist since I was a kid. One day I was babysitting two kids, and I was really struck by what the father of this kid said. He was a physicist, he was working in a university, and he told me something like, a physicist is an artist who can't draw. And then in my school, there was this researcher, this woman who came to explain what she was doing as a particle physicist. And she was so fascinating the way she was talking. And she brought me and two classmates into the physics department. And when people talked about physics, they were always mentioning the word beauty. And then I thought, that's the place where I want to be. With many physicists around the world, we are trying to answer the basic questions about what are the building blocks of nature, the smallest particle that make all the objects you see around you. And to do that, what we do is that we have this huge experiment at CERN, which is called the Large Hadron Collider, where tiny particles, which are protons, are smashed against each other at the speed of light. And this creates a state in terms of energy, which is like the one we had at the Big Bang, at the very beginning of the universe. So asking ourselves what are the smallest particles, the smallest constituents of matter, sheds light on what happened at the beginning of the universe. For example, a big mystery we are trying to solve is what happened. So why there was a lot of energy at the very beginning and no matter? And we know, according to our theory of particles, that whenever you have energy, for example, two very powerful rays of light, they can collide against each other and magically create matter. So it's like E equal to mc squared. The energy produces matter. But this is always created in pair of one particle of matter and one particle of antimatter. However, everything we see around ourselves is made of matter, planets, stars, everything you see. So how comes, what happened at the very beginning of the universe that made matter win against antimatter? This is one of the biggest mysteries we are trying to solve. Another thing that is extremely fascinating is that actually the theory we have about matter only covers 5% of everything that is in the universe. We have no clue of what the 95% is made of. We know that there is an energy that expands the universe, and there is a matter which we call dark matter. However, none of the building blocks we know can be dark matter. So we have still to discover what is it that creates this 30% of the universe, which is dark matter. So with my group, because at the LHC we have protons colliding, but protons, as you might know, they are made of quarks, which are very tiny particles. So, and they are, have fancy names, up, down, charm, strange, beauty, and truth. And they all live inside the proton. And we know that when two protons collide against each other, actually one of these particles comes out and smashes against the other by creating a lot of stuff in the final state, a lot of other particles. So what I try to understand is what is the structure of the proton in terms of the elementary building blocks, which are these quarks. And this is very important because at the moment, one particle that is created out of two protons is this famous Higgs particle, which sometimes the newspaper call the God particle. And if we want to understand what the Higgs is made of and whether this particle can lead us into solving the mysteries of our universe, we have to understand very well what protons are made of. With my group in Cambridge, we use artificial intelligence and machine learning techniques to really get this structure to the highest accuracy we could ever reach. And all these questions we have about matter, antimatter, dark matter, these are pure questions. This is pure science that was not born to lead immediate applications. However, out of these experiments, we had so many new technologies that were invented and a lot of discoveries that improved the health of people and the way in which energy is produced. So I find it really fascinating. So I'm very happy because at Newnham we have a brilliant community of mathematicians. We have senior members, PhD students, master's students, and undergraduates. And we would really like to encourage more women into maths and to join these thriving communities at Newnham and to succeed in whatever you are going to do as a mathematician. Michelangelo, whenever he was doing the sculptures, he was trying to find this. So it was as if the image of the sculptor was trying to come out of the stone, and when he was recognizing it, he was moved and full of wonder in front of something that was already there. He just had to take away the stone to. And that's the same when you do physics, because somehow some law is there, some beautiful math that can explain things, but it's not to be, you know, and you try to work on that to get the simplicity of the idea out. But when I will retire, I will write a book about that. Now it's not possible. So my kids take all the energies out of me. I let you decide whether I am an artist or not. Thank you.